Hutter Street, Newcastle, has undergone vast changes in recent years. A small section of this street at the East End has now been converted to a modern mall. However, in the 70s, motor buses were a predominant part of the traffic scene. But turning the clock back to the 40s, a much more charismatic form of transport carried the people of Newcastle. This being the electric tram. Although many of the trams were destroyed after the tramways closed, some went to varied and unusual locations, such as schools, backyards, bus shelters, and farms. These quaint vehicles have long been extinct from Newcastle streets, but their unique sounds may soon be heard again. One of Newcastle's trams has incredibly been hidden from certain destruction. Number 284 has been resting, in suspended animation, for years on a farm. This is the story of the salvation of 284. Electric trams first ran in Newcastle on the 4th of December 1923 between Telford and Perkin Streets via Hutter Street, and progressive extensions were made to the termini at Mayfield, Merriweather, Glebe, Adamstown, Warner Tower and Wall's End, serving faithfully through the Depression and war years until the tramways closed on the 10th of June 1950. Tram 284 was donated to a group of enthusiasts by the D family. And what a complicated process it was to remove the tram, because it was firmly implanted inside their hayshed. As the shed had been built around the tram, the only way of removing it was through the roof. Screw by screw, the roof sheets were removed. Followed then by the supporting structural timbers basking the roof of 284 in the glorious morning sun for the first time for years. The transporter and crane arrived, unaware of the tricky operation that awaited them. While they prepared for the lifts, dairy farmer Gary D gave background information about the tram.
To my knowledge, the tram's been here for 18 years in this shed, since we've been here. It was in the shed and we used to use it for living quarters. But before that, came up from Newcastle, went into the meatworks' offices, and kept them, when they discarded it, It came here, and it's been in the shed ever since, as far as I can understand. Now, we're sorry to see the tram go, but it's good that it's going back to be restored. It's been used here as a storage room. Any odd pieces of gear we've had to have, just putting the tram out of the road, which we always knew where it was. But now that they've pulled the shed apart, putting it back together again and so forth, it'll be good to see that when it comes up to new, we're going to have a look at it then, see what it should look like. I'm glad they're doing something with it.
After the lifting tackle was attached, 284 was gradually inched skywards into full view, much to the amazement of onlookers. After loading was completed, the destination board was attached. Then departed on the long journey home. Shedding years of accumulated debris. One can but wonder how many times 284 actually rounded this very corner at Robert and Nelson Street's Wall's End in revenue service all those years ago. New home is the historic former railway goods shed at Wall's End, where Newcastle Tramway Museum members have been preparing for its arrival. The delicate operation of manoeuvring the tram into the restricted space was skillfully executed without incident. Unloading completed after its long journey from Aberdeen, 284 slumbers peacefully in her new surroundings, awaiting restoration, alongside an unusual stablemate, an ex-Melbourne W2 class tram car, number 247.
Well, fellas, 284's come home.
Well, she's in remarkably good nick for an old girl.
Yeah, now I got the big job of restoration.
A fight for love and glory, a case of do or die.